Actually open the connection. Hello? My name is Peter, and I was a manager for Freddy's back in 1993. So if you're wondering, yes, you're dead. I'm not sure how you died, but maybe something happened. Wait, it can't be. John? Christ, that would explain why everything looks worse. If you died by burning, then that means he's gonna be here soon. Ah, damn it. Well, you're in whatever godforsaken creation of Fredbear's Diner, warped by an entity with each passing death at any Freddy's establishment. This is like an eternal purgatory for both you and me. We can't see each other, though. This place only lets us see what it wants us to see. I'm hoping this goes well, but I'd rather not think of the implications. As you can probably tell, you have a monitor in that office. You can use it to sort of learn the layout of this hell house. But trust me, you'll be better off doing that. There's only one of them that woke up tonight, and that would be Freddy. He comes by your left. Just swap sides when you're at the monitor and he should leave. Oh, I almost forgot. Since you fucked things up by dying, I've been working on a short plan as we speak. There is a tape in the office. Grab it and play it once Freddy sleeps. There's some things you need to remember. I also have my own set of tapes to collect, so I'd better get to finding them now. We'll talk later. Alright. I'm back. Hopefully you survived last night. Now, you might be wondering why they're all after you when you probably didn't do anything to them. Well, let's just say they see you as sort of a fix, everything MacGuffin for their own damned souls. See, you and I have this source known as plasma because we died, which makes them want to kill us. Again. But unlike us, they've been corrupted. They're in pain, John, and they want to be free. That's why they're after you. They only want to fix their damaged souls. Anyway, you got some newer problems to deal with. There's this bear with no ears. I don't really know where it came from, so I decided to call it Am I Real? Not clever, I know, but they're probably the worst of your troubles as time goes on. Just keep your cameras on them at all times. I'm not sure how you'll keep track of them, though. Then there's Chica. They're blind for some reason, and I think the cupcake might be alive. When you see her on your right, just look at her from the other side and run back when she leaves. The cupcake will try to attack you if you don't. I think someone lost their nose to that thing once. With that all the way, you're all set for tonight. I'm still planning, so I'll let you know when I think of something, John.
You're
Hey, I'm back again. Things are really starting to speed up now, so I'll try to explain things faster for you. There's this weird purple one. They always appear at 6 a.m. for everyone. I'm not sure how it has the power to break into reality, but that's where I hear him every time. Looking at him will jump time for it, since it stabilizes everyone's vision of this place. Then there's this weird metal rod with hands that built both itself. If I'm being honest, it just looks like a bunch of props with small legs, or whatever those are. Almost like it's a soul cage of some sort. It'll try to scare you to death, so just look up afterwards and you should leave because he hates being watched. Now, let me explain some things for you. All these monsters you see, they're all victims of the restaurant murders. Only that shattered mask made them what they are. It got all that plasma to physically shape them from this odd molten rabbit who has been here a really long time. It doesn't take too kindly to having plasma stolen, so I think it intentionally corrupted the plasma, causing all this to happen in the first place. Turning them all into these sort of Frankenstein abominations. Oh, right. I almost forgot. Donnie woke up too. He'll come by the right side, then run to the left side. Just look at him whenever he goes and he'll give up. I'm still working on something to think of to help get out. Until then, good luck, John.